Here is a list of some of the worst deaths in history. Number 1. Hiroshi Uchi. In 1999, Japanese nuclear worker Hiroshi Uchi got a deadly radiation dose when material he worked with got critical. Slowly all his skin fell off. According to the excerpt from the book, after suffering patiently for a week, Uchi suddenly cracked. "I can't take it anymore. I am not guinea pig." His words shocked the physicians and nurses in charge of his treatment. Was this the time to shift the focus from cure to palliative care? Even if a case could be made for persevering a bit longer, what purpose could possibly have been served by resuscitating him on the 59th day, after his heart stopped 3 times for a total of 49 minutes? This was a man whose chromosomes had been destroyed. None of Uchi's chromosomes could be identified or arranged in order. Uchi's body was destroyed from the inside out. It was a slow, painful, and presumably unpreventable death. Surely the doctors should have been able to recognize very early that he could not be saved. Number 2. Junko Furuta. Junko Furuta was a 17-year-old Japanese teenager who was kidnapped by a group of young men. They kept her captive in the house owned by one of their parents. That was the beginning of her 44 days of torture that led to her death. They fed her only cockroaches to eat, only her own urine to drink. Foreign objects inserted into her vagina, and thus including a still-lit light bulb, broken bottles, cigarettes, fireworks. They lit her legs on fire multiple times. There was rape and sodomy every day. She's estimated to have gone through approx. 500 rapes due to her captor's Yakuza ties. She endured constant physical beatings, included hits with golf clubs and bashing of face against cement floor. She was beaten to such an extent that her brain was shrinking from the trauma. She lost bowel control after dumbbells were dropped on her stomach while she lay on the floor with hands and feet bound. She was hung from the ceiling and used as boxing bag. On her last day of custody, she begged for them to just kill her. They challenged her to a game of mahjong solitaire and told her if she won they'd let her go. She did win, but instead of releasing her they beat her with iron barbells and set her legs, arms, face and stomach alight after pouring lighter fluid on them. She went into shock and died the next day. Her corpse was found stuffed into a concrete-filled barrel on a tract of reclaimed land in KMTM, Tokyo. Number 3. Grigori Rasputin. He was poisoned, but he didn't die. So he went after the guys who poisoned him, and they stabbed him. He still didn't die and kept going after the assassins, so they shot him and thought they had finished him. His eyes opened. And he lunged for one of the assassins to strangle him, so they shot him some more, this time he started to crawl away. They then thrashed him, tied him up, threw him in a sack, and threw the sack into the river. 2 days later the sack was recovered, and it looked like Rasputin almost escaped his bindings and clawed out of the bag. To top it all, while his body was being burned, the tendons shrunk and he sat up in the fire. Number 4. David Allen Kerwin. On 20 July 1981. 24-year-old David Allen Kerwin from La Canada, California, was driving through Yellowstone's Fountain Paint Pot thermal area with his friend Ronald Ratliff and Ratliff's dog Moosey. At about 1 p.m. they parked their truck to get out and take a closer look at the hot springs. Moosey escaped from the truck, ran towards nearby Celestine Pool, jumped in, and began yelping. Kerwin and Ratliff rushed over to the pool to aid the terrified dog. And Kerwin's attitude indicated he was about to go into the spring after it. According to bystanders, several people tried to warn Kerwin off by yelling at him not to jump in, but he shouted like hell I won't, back at them, took 2 steps into the pool, and then dove head first into the boiling spring. Kerwin swam out to the dog and attempted to take it to shore. He then disappeared underwater, let go of the dog, and tried to climb out of the pool. Ratliff helped pull Kerwin out of the hot spring, and another visitor led Kerwin to the sidewalk as he reportedly muttered, "That was stupid. How bad am I? That was a stupid thing I did." Kerwin was indeed in very bad shape. He was blind, and when another park visitor tried to remove one of his shoes, his skin came off with it. He sustained third-degree burns to 100% of his body, including his head, and died the following morning at a Salt Lake City hospital. Number 5. People who were sentenced to the boats. The intended victim was stripped naked and then firmly fastened within the interior space of 2 narrow rowing boats, joined together one on top of the other with the head, hands and feet protruding. The condemned was forced to ingest milk and honey to the point of developing a severe bowel movement and diarrhea, and more honey would be poured on him to attract insects, with special attention devoted to the eyes, ears, mouth, genitals, and anus. In some cases, the executioner would mix milk and honey and pour that mixture all over the victim. He would then be left to float on a stagnant pond or be exposed to the sun. The defenseless individual's feces accumulated within the container, attracting more insects which would eat and breed within his exposed flesh which, pursuant to interruption of the blood supply, by burrowing insects became increasingly gangrenous. The individual would lie naked, covered from head to toe in milk, honey, and their own feces. The feeding would be repeated each day in some cases to prolong the torture, so that fatal dehydration or starvation did not occur. Death, when it eventually occurred, was probably due to a combination of dehydration, starvation and septic shock. Delirium would typically set in after a few days. Number 6. Perillos. The brazen bull was a hollow, life-size bronze bull that could fit a man inside of it. Once inside, the only way to draw a breath was from a trumpet-like tube that was attached to the bull's mouth. Once the unfortunate was placed inside, a fire was lit underneath the bull, rapidly heating the interior of the brazen bull. The victim's breath soon turned to shrieks and screams, but the clever design of the mouthpiece turned those shrieks into bull calls. The inventor was roasted inside the bull by the guy he proposed the idea to, since he was so disgusted by Perillo's idea to convert screams to bull calls. He was taken out just before he died and thrown off a hill. The brazen bull was a popular attraction at parties. It was like magic to the guests who had no idea what was actually going on. To them it looked as if the bronze bull statue itself was making the noise in response to the fire beneath it. Number 7. Balthasar Gerards. He was executed for the assassination of William I of Orange. The torturing included being whipped with a lash. After this, his wounds were smeared with honey, so a goat could lick it up. He was forced to sleep with his hands and feet bound together. A weight of 300 pounds was attached to his big toes for half an hour. He was fitted with well-oiled, too small shoes made of uncured dogskin. He was put in front of a fire, so the heat contracted the shoes and crushed his feet. The remainder half-burned skin was torn off. His armpits were branded. He was dressed in a shirt soaked in alcohol, and they poured burning bacon fat over him. If this was not enough, they placed nails between the flesh and nails of hands and feet. The magistrates decreed that the right hand of Gerard should be burned off with a red-hot iron, that his flesh should be torn from his bones with pincers in 6 different places, that he should be quartered and disemboweled alive, his heart torn from his bosom and flung in his face, and that, finally, his head should be taken off. Number 8. Gyorgy Dasa. Gyorgy Dasa was a Hungarian rebel in the 1400s, who was eventually caught, tortured, and executed along with his followers. He was captured and condemned to sit on a heated smoldering iron throne with a heated iron crown on his head and a heated scepter in his hand. While Dasa was suffering, a procession of 9 fellow rebels, who had been starved beforehand, were led to such throne. In the lead was Dasa's younger brother, Gyorgy, who was cut in 3 before Dasa, despite Dasa asking for Gyorgy to be spared. Next, executioners removed hot pliers from fire and forced them into Dasa's skin. After pulling flesh from him, the remaining rebels were ordered to bite where the hot iron had been inserted and to swallow the flesh. Those who refused, about 3 or 4, were simply cut up, which prompted the remaining rebels to do as commanded. In the end, Dasa died on the throne of iron from the damage that was inflicted, while the rebels who obeyed were let go without further harm. Number 9. Deborah Gale Stone. On July 8, 1974, 9 days after the America Sings attraction opened in Disneyland, 18-year-old Disneyland cast member Deborah Gale Stone died when she was crushed between 2 walls of the building. A narrow channel between a stationary wall and a rotating wall was open, and Deborah was unfortunate enough to walk through the space as the rotating wall began to move. One of the audience members heard Deborah's screams and notified park staff, although most people in the audience thought that Deborah's death screams were all part of the show. Number 10. Biford Dolphin Accident. Biford Dolphin is a drilling rig, known most notably for an explosive decompression accident in 1983 that killed 5 workers and badly injured 1. All divers were exposed to the effects of explosive decompression. Subsequent investigation by forensic pathologists determined one of them was exposed to the highest pressure gradient, violently exploding due to the rapid and massive expansion of internal gases. All of his thoracic and abdominal organs, and even his thoracic spine, were ejected, as were all of his limbs. Simultaneously, his remains were expelled through the narrow trunk opening left by the jam chamber door, less than 60 centimeters in diameter. Fragments of his body were found scattered about the rig. One part was even found lying on the rig's derrick, 10 meters directly above the chambers. The deaths of all four divers was most likely instantaneous. If you like this video and want to see more of this content, please like it, subscribe to the channel and click on the bell. And if you didn't like it, then write in the comments what exactly you didn't like. Thank you for the views, see you soon.